I've driven quite a few Mustangs in my day. A couple Shelbys, I've done reviews of a bunch of different Mustang GTs, but I have never been anything close to a Mustang like this. Today we're going to review my buddy Alex's Mustang GT. It's 605 wheel horsepower and 560 pound-feet of torque. Right now I'm in a desolate parking lot, but unfortunately we're going to have to take it out on the road. And I'm gonna do my best to not crash into any crowds. Here we go.
All right, so here we are. It's a 2014 Ford Mustang GT. It's a premium, it has the Recaro package. I'm sure you've seen tons of reviews of this generation Mustang before. It's a 6-speed manual. It's got the touchscreen and everything like that, but honestly, who cares in a car like this? We have a boost meter right here, I care about that. This car does put out 11 PSI of boost. Let's start it up.
Having twin turbos, it obviously muffles the sound a little bit.
although it's still stupid loud. This thing is just ridiculous.
So I decided to stop here and compose myself a little bit so we can go over the mods real quick here so you guys know. I've mentioned this quickly already. I don't want to be repetitive here, but so it's got an 03 twin turbo kit, 67 millimeter turbos. It's got a Boss intake manifold. It's got a steel braided clutch. It's got ABOC Sportline springs, strange adjustable shocks. It's got cat deletes, resonator deletes, pipes, resonated tips, and an MSD two-step. That's what's making these awesome pops. And it's set to 2500 RPM. Are you serious? Sounds like a shotgun. This is just stupid. Oh my God. Oh, my phone's flinging around here. Put that away. Every time I'm about to take this thing out on the road, I feel afraid. Yeah, where there's any kind of turn involved in the road, I stay off the gas pedal. That's how much I don't trust this car. Gets a little droney in here because of not having any resonators and having adjustable rear suspension is supposed to make it safer on the road. I mean, I don't care. I'm not pushing this gas pedal in any kind of turn. Oh, when these turbos spool up, this is just sick. And I've mentioned in several videos before, I'm more of a supercharger guy. I like that sound better, but this is just it's something special by hearing these turbos. I mean, this thing is awesome. What a car. And these recaro seats are very comfortable, actually. Especially a guy my size, they hug me perfectly. They're not too stiff. Now this clutch is a little tricky, you have to play with it. Hopefully I'll survive this on-ramp. Oh, Jesus. Oof. Wow. Oh my God, I mean, it's got so much power. I feel like I can't get the full potential out of this car because it's not enough room. And this road here is known to have quite a few cops hanging out. This thing is just crazy. This is the baddest Mustang I've ever driven. And I've driven a 700 horsepower Shelby, but that didn't have as much personality as this one.
evil personality. Wonder he's bought slicks for this. I mean, you can't push this car without having proper tires, but this thing is just, wow, absolutely insane. What a car. Now, when talking to the owner, Alex, I wanted to get an idea how much he put into this car. How much money has he spent? What does it cost to build a Mustang like this? You know, besides obviously buying the actual car. And he's like, I don't want to think about it. So he doesn't really know, but it's definitely 10,000 plus. Oh my God. But now driving around for a little while here and, you know, really kind of pushing the car, maybe not for a very long distance at a time. Yeah, it wants to squirrel around and you get a lot of wheel spin, but it's not like it really wants to just flip you around and then you're running into a crowd of people. Yeah, I don't really get that feeling. I mean, it is manageable. I think this is, it just feels like a very solid build. I mean, there's a lot of modded Mustangs out there. But with the owner being a Ford tech, he does know what he's doing. And he will be around the tri-state area this season. He will be taking it to the strip mainly. And his goal is to be mid-10s, obviously with his slicks. So this is definitely a very, very capable car, and it's extremely fast. I mean, I've driven cars with more horsepower than this, but I don't think I've ever driven a faster car than this right here. It's something special. Yeah, this thing's stupid. Absolutely stupid. So I hope everybody enjoyed this review. I definitely did. This car scares me to death. So big thanks to my buddy Alex for letting me have his car here for a few hours today and review it for you guys. Look him up on Instagram. As I mentioned already, he'll be around here, the tri-state area, and taking this car to shows, taking it to the track, taking it to the strip. So I'm sure you'll be seeing him around. But if you guys have any additional questions regarding this car, please leave a comment in the comment section below. If I don't know the answer, I'll just ask the owner and I'm sure that he can fill us in. Remember to follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter as well. It's all at AutoVlog. Links will be provided in the description below. If you're stopping by the channel for the first time and you haven't already, please subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time.